Hi everyone, welcome to another episode of Garden to Table. We're bringing the kitchen right into the garden today, and we're going to turn this massive eggplant into eggplant bacon. Now you're going to want to stay tuned with this video because by the end, you're going to know exactly how to make this recipe and eat it on a delicious ELT sandwich. Thank you so much for joining me here in the garden for the Garden to Table recipes. It's really been a lot of fun, and I hope you've been able to make some of them. So comment below, let me know which recipes you've tried and how you like them. Well, I just harvested this massive eggplant from my garden last week. Hopefully you're able to catch that video. It was so much fun. But eggplant bacon is insanely delicious. It's slightly smoky, salty, a little bit chewy, super easy to make. So let's go over the ingredients and we'll get started. For this recipe, you're going to need one medium eggplant. I'm going to use about half of this massive eggplant. 2 tablespoons of olive oil, 1.5 tablespoons of soy sauce, 1 tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce, 1 tablespoon of pure maple syrup, 2 teaspoons of liquid smoke, 1 teaspoon of smoked paprika, and some fresh ground pepper. Now, I got this recipe from a great website called theminimalistbaker.com, and I'll put a link in the video description. But first, what we want to do is cut up our eggplant. Now, I really hate to cut this beautiful eggplant because it is such a gorgeous eggplant. It's the most massive eggplant I've ever harvested from my garden, but it's got to be done. So here we go. We're going to cut our eggplant in half lengthwise. Oh, this is so pretty. I just can't hardly bear to cut into it. Here we go. Oh, this is a gorgeous, gorgeous eggplant. Look at that. There's not even a ton of seeds in it. I mean, this is absolutely perfectly ripe, and I will be saving the seeds from one of these halves. And I'm just going to trim off this top part with the stem part on it. I'm going to cut my eggplant in half again, and we're going to cut it into bacon-like strips. Now I'm going to cut these a little bit thicker than paper thin. You definitely want to keep them very thin strips, and you definitely want to have a very sharp knife. See how thin those strips are? Try and cut them as uniform as you can. Then I'm going to cut my slices into bacon-like strips. Oh, my mouth is already watering. We're going to lay our bacon strips on a baking sheet lined with parchment paper. And in the meantime, I have my oven heating up in the house to 300 degrees. I actually have another baking sheet in my oven that's preheating, and then I'll transfer this parchment paper onto the heated baking sheet, which is going to help it get nice and crispy. And now we're going to make our marinade for the eggplant bacon. Now for the best part, the smoky, salty, delicious marinade. This stuff is absolutely amazing. You guys are going to absolutely love it. So we're going to first take 2 tablespoons of olive oil, put it into our bowl here. Then we're going to add 1.5 tablespoons of soy sauce. We're going to take 1 tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce. Don't you just love saying Worcestershire? For some reason, I always have a hard time saying that. But I really, really love Worcestershire. Then we're going to do 1 tablespoon of maple syrup to add a delicious, sweet flavor to our eggplant bacon. And seriously, guys, you have got to try this recipe. I know eggplant bacon sounds a little bit unusual. I thought so too. But I just can't get enough of it now. The next 2 ingredients are the secret ingredients to the recipe, and that is liquid smoke and smoked paprika. And you really have to have the smoked paprika. It just adds that nice smoky flavor, and you really can't do it without it. But it's super easy to find. You can usually get it at Target, Walmart. This I got at Trader Joe's, and this Applewood liquid smoke is absolutely amazing. So we're going to add 2 teaspoons of the liquid smoke. Oh, smells good already. And we are going to add 1 teaspoon of the smoked paprika. Now you can always play around with the ingredients here and customize it to whatever you like. I'm going to add a little bit more because we like that nice smoky flavor. Look at that color. Isn't that beautiful? I'm going to give it a little stir around with my fork here. just to combine all the ingredients. Okay, there you have it. That's all it is to making the marinade. So, so delicious. Now we're gonna put it on the eggplant. This is where it gets fun. This marinade adds such a gorgeous color to this eggplant. I mean, it's already beautiful enough, but I'm just gonna brush it here with my pastry brush on each piece, and look at that. Nice and crispy, but slightly chewy, all cooked up in the oven. It's kind of a sweet, smoky, salty scent, if there is such a thing. So I'm gonna turn my pieces over so we make sure it's got that nice smoky flavor all throughout. And then we're gonna pop it in the oven. Now the great thing about this is it's a delicious vegetarian meal. You could also add to your ELT a sliced piece of ham or chicken or anything you like if you like a little bit more of a hearty sandwich. Oh, this smells so good. Oh, I just can't wait to get this in the oven and take it out and show you guys how wonderful this eggplant bacon is. My oven is preheated to 300 degrees Fahrenheit, and I have a baking sheet also preheating in my oven. So I'm gonna transfer my parchment paper onto my baking sheet in my oven. And I really do like to preheat my baking sheets because I feel like that just makes things a little crisper and cook a little bit nicer. So I'm just gonna take my parchment paper very carefully, transfer it to my baking sheet. And I'm gonna bake this for about 40 minutes, but I'm gonna start checking it after 20 minutes, and I wanna cook it until it's nice and crispy and just a little bit soft. Well, my eggplant bacon's been in the oven for about 25 minutes, and it is important that you check your eggplant bacon regularly because every oven is different. But I'm gonna just pull it out. And it's not quite ready yet. You can see it's still a little bit too soft, but I am gonna go ahead and flip it over to make sure that it gets baked evenly on every side and nice and browned. So I'm gonna flip it over, and then we're gonna put it back in and check it every 5 minutes to make sure it doesn't get burnt. Okay, I think our eggplant bacon is ready to come out of the oven. Oh, perfect. See how it's just slightly brown, it's not blackened, it's a little bit soft still, but looking pretty crispy. So we're gonna pull it out. Oh. Well, this is so much fun to bring this out in the garden, and what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna transfer it here to this platter. Oh, I gotta try a piece. I just can't wait any longer. I mean, you know when you cook, and you gotta try what you've made. Oh, this is heaven. So, so good. We're gonna make an ELTA, an eggplant, lettuce, tomato, avocado sandwich, and we gotta harvest the L and the T from the garden. Well, the first thing we're going to harvest is our L. I'm gonna harvest one of these absolutely gorgeous giant red mustard greens. These have a nice, beautiful, incredible, stunning red color, and such a tasty zip they're gonna add to our salad. Well, I have two tomato plants left on my Kellogg's breakfast tomato plant, and I've been saving them especially for this video. So I'm just gonna harvest these two tomatoes. Oh, these are so beautiful. These are my favorite tomatoes. This tomato is actually quite a bit overripe, just because I have been saving it for this video. Oh, this is gorgeous. So I washed off my greens and my tomato in the hose and patted them dry. And to make my sandwich, I've got two slices of sprouted grain bread and the A, the avocado. So let's get to making this baby. First, I'm going to cut my avocado in half and mash it up. If you have an avocado tree in your garden, you are very, very lucky because you could use fresh avocados. Just gonna scoop out the insides. Oh, this looks so tasty. And we're gonna give that a good little mash with the fork. Could throw a little bit of salt and pepper in there if you want. You gotta have fresh ground pepper. A little sea salt, add a little bit of flavor in there. Could even squeeze a little bit of lemon in there if you want. And we are gonna spread that on our toasted sprouted grain bread. If you wanna use mayonnaise, you can use mayonnaise. But I love putting avocado on this ELT sandwich. OK, Okay, next step, we are going to slice up our tomato, our beautiful Kellogg's breakfast tomato. Oh, this is so pretty. My favorite tomato. Just gonna slice it in half. And this tomato knife really does the job here on these tomatoes without squishing them. Cut that little dry part off on the top. And we are gonna slice this baby up. Don't you just love slicing into a beautiful garden fresh tomato? Now let's build our sandwich. We're gonna take this massive, giant red mustard leaf. Look at this thing. I mean, this is huge. I'm just gonna load it up here with this mustard green. Put that on my sandwich. Gorgeous Kellogg's breakfast tomato. And we are gonna top this yummy looking sandwich with some of this eggplant bacon. Oh my goodness. I cannot believe this. It looks just like bacon. Okay, we are gonna top it with our slice of bread. We gotta cut this baby up because I'm not gonna be able to wait any longer to get a bite. It's so big and thick, I can't even cut it. Wow. This looks absolutely amazing. Okay guys, here we go. Going in for the taste test. Eggplant ELT sandwich, ELTA. Oh my goodness, the flavor. Tastes just like bacon. This is so, so delicious. Well, now you guys know exactly how to make this eggplant bacon and how to make a delicious ELTA sandwich. So now you go out and try it and comment below and let me know how it went. So make sure you like this video, share it with your friends, and subscribe so you don't miss the future videos. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video.